anchor your life to the inspiring words that will put a rainbow in your sky. Listen to Word and Songs, a program that will introduce you to the Word of Life and beautiful music to help you experience peace and consolation. Join the Daughters of St. Paul for half an hour of Word and Songs.
Hello there, dear friend in Christ. How are you? How are you coping with the daily challenges brought about by the COVID-19 pandemic? I hope and pray you're firmly grounded in your faith in God and see this pandemic as an occasion to reflect more deeply into your life and your relation with God and His creation. As Pope Francis says in Laudato Si number 160, when we ask ourselves what kind of world we want to leave behind, we think in the first place of its general direction, its meaning, and its values. Unless we struggle with these deeper issues, I do not believe that our concern for ecology will produce significant results. But if these issues are courageously faced, we are led inexorably to ask other pointed questions. What is the purpose of our life in this world? Why are we here? What is the goal of our work and all our efforts? What need does the earth have of us? I'm Sister Lines Bador of St. Paul, inviting you to join me for half an hour here in our program, Word and Songs, nourishing your soul with the Word of God and inspiring you with music beating from the heart. As we continue celebrating the season of creation from September 1 to October 4, we'll get to know more this ecumenical celebration and reflect why we need to consider the care of our common home seriously, especially in the light of the COVID-19 pandemic we are experiencing. The pandemic is a wake-up call to all of us to care for God's creation. Our sister Mother Earth, who sustains and governs us, and who produces various fruit with colored flowers and herbs, now cries out to us because of the harm we have inflicted on her by our irresponsible use and abuse of the goods with which God has endowed her. So, may I now invite you, friend, to sit back and relax as we allow the Lord to speak to us personally in this program. Meanwhile, may we listen to our first song.
Beautiful, strong, endless connecting, winding from one to
we are one.
beautifully sung by Sister Bubbles Bandoho, RC, you've just heard Web of Life from Prayers from the Upper Room album. Yes, my dear friend, we are one with the trees, one with the earth, the sky, and the seas. We are branches of God rooted deep in life. If we are mindful of our connectedness with the rest of God's creation, we can't help but do the best we can in protecting and preserving the beauty of our common home. So, what is the season of creation? The season of creation is a month-long prayerful observance, 34 days to be exact, that calls the planet's 2.2 billion Christians to pray and care for God's creation. It begins September 1, the World Day of Prayer for the Care of Creation, and concludes October 4, the Feast of St. Francis of Assisi, the patron saint of ecology. It's a time to reflect on our relationship with the environment, not just distant nature, but, crucially, the place where we live, and the ways in which our lifestyles and decisions as a society can endanger both the natural world and those inhabiting it, both humans and other creatures. The Ecumenical Steering Committee that plans and promotes the season each year put it this way. The season of creation is a time to renew our relationship with our Creator and all creation through celebration, conversion, and commitment together. During the season of creation, we join our sisters and brothers in the ecumenical family in prayer and action for our common home. It's a time of prayer, contemplation, and increasingly calls to action. Up next is a song that glorifies God for the gift of His creation.
He wraps Himself in light as with a garment. He spreads out the heavens and walks on the wings of the wind. He sends forth the springs from the valleys. They flow between mountains. The birds of the air dwell by the waters, lifting their voices in song, singing glory, glory, glory to the Lamb. All praises and honor its setting. He looks at the earth and it trembles. He touches the mountains and they smoke. I will sing to the Lord all my life. I will sing praises to my God. As long as I live, praises to the Lord, oh my soul. Singing glory, glory, glory to the Lamb. All praises and honor forever.
You've just heard Fernando Ortega with his inspiring rendition of Creation Song. Friend, in 1989, Ecumenical Patriarch Demetrius I initiated the World Day of Prayer for Creation, celebrated on September 1st each year as an ecumenical effort to respond to the ecological crisis facing the human community. In 2015, Pope Francis joined the ecumenical effort, adding this day of prayer to the Catholic liturgical calendar. Faith communities around the world have since developed the celebration into the season of creation, extending the prayer for creation to the feast of Saint Francis of Assisi, whose love of God in creation is legendary and widely revered in many faith traditions globally. The season of creation is supported by a number of leading Christian organizations, including the World Council of Churches, Christian Aid, the Lutheran World Federation, the Anglican Communion Environmental Network, the Global Catholic Climate Movement, and the Vatican's Dicastery for the Promotion of Integral Human Development. It sits in the System of Creation Steering Committee. Coming Your Way is a song of creation by Bukas Palad Music Ministry.
Sing as one from man's lost his melody. A hungry child, a dying sea, a naked forest of enmity. All foretold man has lost his memory. The song of his destiny, the whole world needs to sing and dance. The song of our creation as God's one family. Creatures great and small for delivery they call. The song of our ancestry lies deep in our memory. The sick is in our love with all the other fading song. With mother river and father hill and brother eagle, sister daffodil, to sing as one as on the day the world began. When Yahweh said,
the song of a people's salvation.
You are tuned in to Word and Songs, and this is still your friend, Sister Lines Abedorb St. Paul. Friend, just months after publishing his 2015 encyclical Laudato Si on care for our common home, Pope Francis formally added the World Day of Prayer for the Care of Creation to the Catholic calendar as an annual day of prayer. He said, "Now is the time to rediscover our vocation as children of God, brothers and sisters, and stewards of creation. Now is the time to repent, to be converted, and to return to our roots. We are beloved creatures of God, who in His goodness calls us to love life and live it in communion with the rest of creation. For this reason, I strongly encourage the faithful to pray in these days that as a result of a timely ecumenical initiative are being celebrated as a season of creation. This year, organizers suggested a theme, Jubilee for the Earth, New Rhythms, New Hope. Jubilee in biblical terms refers to a period of restoration every 50 years when the land rests and justice is restored. The theme is, in part, a nod to the 50th celebration of Earth Day, which occurred in April. The global coronavirus pandemic came as the planet nears climate tipping points, and this shows how social, economic, and ecological realities are interconnected, the Season of Creation Steering Committee said in explaining the theme.
Morning has broken like the first morning. Blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Praise for the sea. Praise for the morning, praise for them springing fresh from the world. Sweet the rains new fall, sunlit from heaven. Like the first dew fall on the first grass. Praise for the sweetness of the wet garden, sprung in completeness where his feet is the sunlight, mine is the morning, born of the one light, Eden saw play. Praise with elation, praise every morning, God's recreation of the new. First morning, blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Praise for the singing, praise for the morning, praise for them springing fresh from the world.
What a beautiful song to praise and thank God for the gift of His creation. A Christian hymn written by English author Eleanor Fargeon, first published in 1931 and popularized by Cat Stevens in 1971. We've just heard the timeless hit song, Morning Has Broken. Friend, during the season of creation this year, we enter a time of restoration and hope, a jubilee for our earth that requires radically new ways of living with creation, including the need for just and sustainable systems, to take better care of both people and planet. The Vatican's Integral Human Development Department highlighted the theme earlier this year in announcing a special year-long celebration for the 5th anniversary of Laudato Si. It expressed hope that the coming decade might become a jubilee time for the Earth. The 2020 theme Jubilee for the Earth invites us to consider the integral relationship between rest for the Earth and ecological, economic, social, and political ways of living. This particular year, the need for just and sustainable system has been revealed by the far-reaching effects of the global COVID-19 pandemic. The pandemic has amply revealed that we have pushed the planet to its limit and she cannot take it anymore. Our never-ending desire for more, an exploitation of creation, and an ethical production and consumption have exhausted the planet. Our land, water, forests, and oceans are distressingly struggling to be renewed. There you are, friend. I hope this episode of Word and Song enkindles in us awareness of our moral responsibility to respond to the urgent challenge to protect our common home. This includes a concern to bring the whole human family together to seek a sustainable and integral development, for we know that things can change. The Creator does not abandon us. He never forsakes His loving plan or repents of having created us. Humanity still has the ability to work together in building our common home. Join me now in praying the prayer for the 5th anniversary of Laudato Si. Loving God, Creator of heaven, of earth, and of all that they contain, open our mind and touch our hearts so that we can be part of creation, your gift. Be present to the needy in these difficult times, especially the poorest and most vulnerable. Help us to show creative solidarity in addressing the consequences of this global pandemic. Make us courageous in embracing the changes geared to the search for the common good. Now, more than ever, may we be able to feel that we are all interconnected and interdependent. Make sure that we succeed in listening and responding to the cry of the earth and to the cry of the poor. May the present sufferings be the birth pangs of a more loving and sustainable world. We pray to you through Christ our Lord, under the loving gaze of Mary, help of Christians. Amen. At this point, I'd like to acknowledge and thank the sources of my sharing. From the various resources published in www.seasonofcreation.org and some thoughts from Pope Francis' encyclical letter, Laudato Si, on care for our common home. Thank you so much for the insightful reflection. Likewise, a special thanks to all the composers, producers, and artists of the songs featured in this program. Web of Life from Prayers from the Upper Room album, Creation Song by Fernando Ortega, Song of Creation from Best of Bukas Palad, Volume 2, Morning Has Broken by Cat Stevens, and What a Wonderful World by Louis Armstrong for our final song. Thank you very much. May you continue to inspire the world with your gift of music, and may your music always communicate the love of God to His people. To those of you who follow us in YouTube and Facebook, thank you for listening. Remember, Pauline's Radio PH is linking lives and healing hearts. And if you're searching for spiritual books and media materials that would help enrich your spiritual life, do visit any Pauline's Media Center nearest you or visit our website www.store.paulines.ph. Let me end this program by asking our Creator God to forgive us and guide us to become responsible caretakers of creation, ready to act and advocate for the good of the entire planet. May our praises to God for the gift of creation energize us to see, reflect, and act in the spirit of Jesus, now and through time to come. This has been Sister Lines Badar of St. Paul saying, bye-bye for now. Thank you so much for keeping me company. Join me again next week for another episode of Word and Songs. Happy celebration of Season of Creation. Stay safe, everyone. God bless us always.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry, I watch them grow. Like much more than I ever knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Just heard Word and Songs. This program was brought to you by the Daughters of St. Paul.